How you doing today? My name is Alan Edwards, and I'm one of the assistant men's basketball coaches here at the University of Wyoming. And today, I just want to show you two key concepts that we're going to use throughout the season, that when you guys come out and watch us on TV, you'll be able to relate to it. I got the four freshman class that's here with me. I got Big JB, Jonathan Barnes, freshman, Jeremy Lieberman, Tyrell Williams, and Alex Borst. We got to get that name out. All right, guys, come on real quick. You meet Al on the wing. And let's say Jeremy Garvin. Put Tyrell out here. So JB, finish one of the time. We didn't bring the ball, sorry. But two things within our defense is what you will understand is a lot of it is predicated on scouting reports. So when we're in a situation of closing out on the perimeter, it depends on how well the guy shoots the ball from three-point range versus how well he drives the ball. So if Jeremy was in help position and the ball was skipped, say Tyrell had the ball and Jonathan was guarding Tyrell, and he was on help side. Sorry, we're going to have a floor down. If the ball was skipped to Alex, who's a really good shooter, we would tell Jeremy in our scouting report that we have to close out very hard and make him play inside the three-point line. We obviously don't want to give him uncontested or open three-point shots. But while that action is going on his closeout, while JB was on the ball and he was guarding Tyrell, like a little bit real, as the ball released from his hands, it's JB's responsibility to now get to the midline. And if you can remember from our first year being here, we were one of the best teams in the country at taking charges because we were always a help-side defensive team. So once Jeremy's on the ball, and there'll be some times where he kind of closes out, maybe out of control, but as long as he puts it on the floor, and our biggest thing is never give up middle of the floor. We will always want to give up baseline because our help is always built on the baseline side. It's hard to take away options when the ball is coming to the middle of the floor versus it going baseline. So if Jeremy's playing with a no middle stance, his right leg up, his left leg back, he's telling Alex that he's not shooting it, but at the same time forcing the baseline. So as Alex, pretend that you have a basketball, drive baseline. If for some reason on the closeout or within just playing one-on-one defense, Jeremy gets beat, it's Jonathan's responsibility to get outside the lane line and step up and take the charge. And like I said, our first year we were really, really good at it, especially with the old rules. And last year it kind of lacked a little bit because they changed the rules, but now we're back. So if Al was to come, it's his responsibility to take up him and take a wall. And obviously we're going to have five guys here, but the opposite guy will rotate down to obviously take Jonathan's man. So go back real quick. Let's say you're on help side. Let's say the ball starts here this time. Tyrell, back up a little bit. Now, for the purpose of this drill, we're saying Tyrell is a non-shooter. Right? So instead of closing out hard to take away the three-point shot, if you can remember some of our games last year, especially more so with fives and fours, if they're non-shooters, on the ball getting skipped, instead of Jonathan running all the way out to Tyrell, he may stop short because we're inviting that guy to shoot the basketball because we're taking our chances from a percentage standpoint and saying that he's not going to be able to beat us by making three-point shots. But at the same time, regardless of the situation, once that ball leaves his hands, Alex's hands, it's Jeremy's responsibility to get the help side. Now, once we realize that he's not going to shoot the ball, now JB can squeak up to now put his hand, put pressure on the ball with active hands so that Tyrell in this position can't make a beeline pass to Alex, because that's a tough situation for Jeremy to recover in if it's a beeline pass. So active hands on the ball, we always tell our guys, for our defense to be successful, they have to make floating passes versus direct passes. So once JB makes sure that he doesn't drive the ball because we want him to shoot it, squeak up, now gets pressure on the ball with his hands and forces him to make a floating pass versus a direct pass. So within our defense, there was a two concepts that our guys would have to know going in, obviously scout report and how we're going to close out on guys, and then help side responsibility. And then obviously, once we close out, forcing guys baseline versus to the middle of the floor.